Hey, what's up, guys? Tanley here, bringing you guys some more Tower Fantasy news. As always, if you guys could leave a like and subscribe, as to let the algorithm know to show this video out to way more people. And only 11% of you guys watching my videos are actually subscribed. So let's change that number, get it to at least 15%, and see what we can do. Just recently, Hotta Studio released a brand new video showcasing some new features in the game, including cooking, and actually revealed two new mini-bosses in the world, so, as we normally do in this channel, we're gonna be analyzing it and looking through what they showed us. From the very beginning of the video, it's showing off beautiful landscapes and kind of talking about what Idastar has to offer, saying that it has the most stunning natural landscape in the universe, with grasslands, islands, snowy mountains, and coastlines. They say that pioneers have never actually tied themselves to a boring food list and have a broad understanding of food, which probably implies that there will be quite a few recipes in the game itself. They seek inspiration through the four seasons in the world while traveling and dig, surf, swim, and climb to get whatever ingredients that they have to, which also implies that there will be many different ways to get these ingredients in the game itself. But again, this isn't primarily to talk about food. At multiple points through the video, it shows off the crayfish, a robot enemy that seems to look like a crab lobster thing. I just think it looks really sick. You can see the player in this video fighting it and trying to get its ingredients. As it is said, it actually drops crayfish meat that you can use to cook. It's very interesting to see Hotta Studio continue to add more world bosses. I don't know if I've ever seen this world boss before, so this may be the first time we're seeing it, and this might be a completely new reveal. But in general, I just think that adding world bosses in the world adds something different to the things you can do. In Genshin Impact, it got kind of boring fighting against the same couple world bosses, so being able to have a broad variety of big battles you can have across the world gives us something different to do when we're not going on quests or farming for materials. Later, it shows the player on a mount, a motorbike. We haven't seen Hotta Studio reveal many of the mounts, although I think we're gonna have a broad selection of mounts to choose from because it's more money for them. However, I hope that all these mounts end up being creative, but that's not really a big point in the video. Especially if the world is as big as they say it is, mounts and fast travel will really help make the world feel a little bit smaller while also leaving room for exploration while you're going around. In the video themselves, they describe the crayfish fight as actually difficult. It requires some level of skill and actual good items. So don't go into this expecting an easy fight. Watching everything back now, it seems like everything's pretty polished actually. They're really only doing the finishing touches. I think this game is really ready for a release at the end of this year, with the rumored release date being November 25th. So hopefully they don't change that. Later on, the player is introduced to the Mushroom Man, another mini boss in the world, who drops a certain special kind of mushroom that can be used to cook as well. I love what Hotta Studio is doing with this video. It's a good way to reveal world bosses as well as show off another mechanic in the game. Though we only saw a very short glimpse of the Mushroom Man, he did seem like another fun world boss you could run into and do with some friends. Again, it's all about adding variety to the world, adding something different to do to the world. I can't stress this enough. If the world is boring and doesn't have a lot to do in it, players will get bored and just leave. So I think that they're trying to add as much stuff as they can to make the world engaging and fun to actually be a part of. This, tied with the game being an MMO, seems like just the perfect setup for success. The only thing I could hope for is this game coming on PlayStation and Xbox. If this game comes out on consoles, it's a wrap, it's done, it's over. However, the game coming out on consoles is better suited for a global release than it is for a domestic release. So there is still hope for that coming in the future. Lastly, we get to see the cooking pot itself. I know, crazy. After you've collected all the materials that you need and all the ingredients that you need, it's a pretty simple process, kind of similar to Zelda's actually. You put up to 5 ingredients together in recipes that you may already know, and then, after a bit, you can craft them. However, there is a chance, if you put in the wrong ingredient, it can come out as a very disgusting plate that no one would want to eat ever. Truthfully, I don't know if you can do like an automatic recipe. I could assume you would just to do like fast recipes because I don't think they want everyone to have to remember all of the recipes. But from what we saw, this is just all that we're given. But every day more and more, the world of Idastar grows and we get to see more stuff that this team is adding. I am so excited for this game to really just do amazing on launch. I think this game will have a very strong community. I think that we'll have a great time. And me and my VPN will get to know each other a little bit better when the game comes out in China. But hey, what did you see that excited you the most? Let me know in the comment section down below. Is there anything more that you're looking forward to in the game? Are there any world bosses that you think would be cool to be added? Again, let me know. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll be sure to see you again in the next video. And I'm out. See ya.